Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, a mathematics teacher. We are in today's lesson, Form 2 Work, Lesson 1, and the topic is cubes and cube roots, and the subtopic is cubes. On to the lesson objective. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to explain how to calculate cubes using a multiplication method and also number B, calculate cubes using a mathematical table, especially the cube tables. And to the multiplication method, example one, you are required to calculate the cube of 25. What are you supposed to do? You are supposed to multiply 25 by itself three times, meaning that the 25 to power 3, that is the cube of 25, it becomes 25 times 25 times 25. And the first solution, you're supposed to multiply by 25 by 25, and you will end up getting 625. That is the step number one. You take 25, you multiply by 25, and the answer becomes 625. And the next step, you're supposed to take the 625, then you further multiply by 25, then the answer becomes 15,625. And therefore, that is becomes 15,625 as the answer of 25 to power 3, or the cube of 25. Then from there, we will go to multiplication method. If you are given a decimal point, what are you supposed to do? If a decimal point is given, you are supposed to multiply, you eliminate the decimals first, you work with 25 as we did in the first method. So you multiply 25 times 25, you get 625, then you further multiply 625 by 25, you get 15,625. Then you count the number of decimal places. You can see in this case, they are supposed to be 3. And therefore, you're supposed to move 3 steps backward. And therefore, the answer, the point will rest, will move from in between 5 and 0 and up to 5 and 6. And therefore, the answer becomes 15.625 as the answer. Then from there, we can look on another example, use of mathematical table. On the mathematical table, we have 3 columns. And the first column, we have the X column. And also, we have the middle column. The middle columns run from 0 up to 9. 0 up to 9. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 9. And also, we have another column which runs from 1 up to 9 still. And therefore, as far as the first question is concerned, you are told find the cube of the following using mathematical table. The number is 0.002563. So what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to convert this number into standard form. And by writing it in standard form, you will get it as 2.563 to power 3, because it is a cube, times 10 to power negative 3, because the decimal has moved 3 steps toward the right hand side. And also power 3, power 3 to power negative 3, then you raise to power 3 again. And therefore, the answer, you look at the cube tables in the X column. You can see in the X column, we have somewhere we have 2.5. And therefore, 2.5 is here in the X column. And then you move to 6 in the middle column. Point 6, the 6 is here. You read the number, which is, you drop up to where the column of 2.5, where it coincides with the row of 2.5, where it is coincide with 6. And the answer becomes 16.777. Then from there, you go to the fourth figure, that is 3, and that one should be read from the third column. And in the third column, You are supposed to look at where we have the digit 3. And the digit 3 is here, and the number digit 3, which coincide with the row where in the X column where 2.5 is 58. So what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to add 58 in the resulting answer, that is 16.777. You add 58, and therefore you will end up getting 7 plus 8, you get 15 car 1. 7 plus 1, that is 8. 8 plus 5, you get 13 car 1. Then plus 1, you get 8. Then the decimal drops there. Then 6, you drop it, and also you drop 1. And therefore, it becomes 16.835. And this was 10 to the power negative 3. So you negative 3, you multiply by 3 because it is a cube. You will get 10 to the power 9. And this one, if you write this one in standard form, it becomes 1.6835 times 10 to the power 1. And because 10 to the power 1, 1 is positive, and there is 10 to the power negative 9, you add the powers. So positive 1 plus minus 9, you will get negative 8. And therefore, the answer becomes 1.6835 times 10 to the power 8. And that is the overall answer. We have come to the end of today's lesson. I hope you have followed. And I'm going to give you the following question as an assignment. The question reads, calculate the you are supposed to calculate the cube, not the reciprocal. There is an error there. You're supposed to calculate the cube of the following using the cube tables. So you are supposed to calculate the cube of 0.00437 and the cube of 3729 and also the cube of 47.97 using the cube tables. For reference, you can refer from Secondary Mathematics Student Book 2, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can contact us at LMTV using the following addresses. You can see them well displayed for you. You can use either of them. And finally, we have the Twitter here at LMTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson.